A study by the non-profit group, the Committee to Protect Journalists, says that in 2011, the Horn of Africa was one of the world's worst places for the press. VOA's Paul Ndiho recently asked Mohammed Keita, an advocacy coordinator for CPJ, about press freedoms in Africa.
We counted at the end of last year that at least 300 journalists had fled Africa because of persecution over the last decade. So last year was a year where we were able to look back at the last decade, and the numbers are just staggering, especially journalists fleeing the Horn of Africa region, the countries like Somalia, Eritrea, Ethiopia. We're also seeing the use of anti-terrorism laws. More and more governments appear to be using these security laws to jail critical reporting.
Considering the fact that most of these autocratic leaders are using some of those new laws enacted in their constitutions to go after the journalists who are critical to them, I wonder how many of such cases are reported to you guys.
We're following very closely, especially what's happening in Ethiopia, where the government has enacted a series of laws that criminalize the legitimate news gathering activities of journalists, especially coverage of opposition groups. And currently, there are at least seven journalists behind bars in Ethiopia. Five of them are being tried for terrorism. And the evidence presented against them are articles posted on the internet or communications between them and some opposition groups.
What are you as a CPJ doing about that? Are you reaching out to some of these countries and challenging them and calling them out and telling them they can't do that?
Absolutely. We were in South Africa in December. We had a meeting with the head of the ANC, the spokesman of the ANC, and we conveyed our concerns, especially the fact that South Africa's image around the world is taking a hit. South Africa should not follow the path of Zimbabwe or other repressive governments.
Your report talks about journalists being detained, being beaten up, some of them being killed. In 2000, I was a victim of that. I was roughed up by rebels fighting in the Congo. They beat me up and took everything that I had. I wonder how many of those cases get reported to CPJ.
We get reports about such incidents just about every day around the continent. We do follow up on every incident. We do talk to officials. We do call on authorities to investigate these incidents. But largely, they happen with total impunity. Very rarely are officials or security forces involved held to account.
Are you in a position to reach out to some of these journalists who have been arrested or tortured or who are hanging somewhere in jails?
Yes, we're able to reach just about every journalist on the continent that is abused because mobile technology has really connected everyone in Africa to the world. So we're able to reach journalists in the most remote parts of the DRC or Zimbabwe. The issue really is about the institutions in Africa and their strength. And in many cases, the police and the judiciary are just too weak to carry out serious investigations, to hold people to account. And I think it's also a matter of the lack of political will.
What's your assessment? Are there countries that are fairly doing well, or all the countries are on a downward spiral?
Unfortunately, most countries are in a downward spiral. If you think about the 1990s, so much progress was made with liberalization of the press, multi-party democracy. But we see that a lot of the leaders that were hailed as reformers in the 90s, such as Prime Minister Meles Zenawi of Ethiopia, or Paul Kagame of Rwanda, have actually grown more authoritarian and are now likening dissent or independent journalism as treasonous or anti-state or anti-development activities.
Where does Africa rank in terms of press freedom?
Africa is still one of the most volatile regions. It has the country that is the deadliest for journalists, one of the deadliest, Somalia, and Eritrea ranks as only the world's second most foremost jailer of journalists. It trails only Iran in imprisonments of journalists. It's the region that has driven the most journalists into exile over the last decade.
That was our Paul Ndiho interviewing Mohammed Keita, an advocacy coordinator for the Committee to Protect Journalists.